Hey guys, it's Sandro here from Carcraft Auto Detailing in Melbourne. Today's video is part 2 of how to professionally detail an interior. In part 1, I covered the primary steps I go through, from firstly working out what the client is looking to achieve, the pre-inspection, plan of attack, and getting started with the floor mats and full interior surface vacuum. In this part, I'll be covering some of the steam cleaning, the door jams, and a thorough full interior surface clean with protective dressing applied. As I stated in part 1, the steps I'm going through and the tools, products, and techniques I'm using are appropriate for this detail. And although most can be used to address many diverse interiors, each job is different and you need to adapt your method to address each situation as appropriate. I also mentioned that this car was recently detailed by the dealership and the door jams are actually 80% or so clean. It's just the finer details around the rubber seals and panel edges that haven't been addressed. If these door jams were caked in mud and gunk, I would have cleaned them before doing the vacuuming, and I'd firstly give them a degreasing and brush down, or more likely hit them with my Tornadol and then rinse them down. But like I said in part 1, I'll always try to use the least aggressive method. And for door jams like these, a straight steam clean followed by a wipe down is all that's needed to address the areas that the previous detail missed. The great thing about a quality steamer is that it has the ability to use both heat and pressure to safely loosen and dislodge embedded grime, without the need of chemicals or leaving behind any residue other than the slightest of water that actually mostly evaporates. And it also has the benefit of sanitizing the surface. And really, the less you can get away with physically touching painted surfaces like door jams, the better, with steamers having the added bonus of being able to reach tight areas that you can struggle to fit your hand in. Once the door jams have been addressed, on a detail like this, I like to give the air vents a good blast to help dislodge and remove particles in the car's air cycle system to reduce dust in the future, as well as clean the surface of the outer vent flaps that love to accumulate dust and grease. I'll also use the steamer to give the roof liner a quick blast to dislodge and help address a bit of stale smoke smell that usually mostly loves to settle directly above the driver's head. As I mentioned, you generally don't want to touch headliners more than is necessary, but as long as you keep the steamer moving and keep it a couple of inches away from the liner, it's one of the best and safest ways to clean them and help remove odors. Then follow it up with a light mopping up with your microfiber cloth to absorb any standing water and to pick up any loosened dust or dirt. The steamer could then go on to be used for cleaning all the plastic, vinyls, and really most surfaces, as I've used it to do so many times. But again, based on my pre-inspection condition and on the other interior cleaning and sanitizing products I'm going to be using, it's not appropriate or the best option for this job. The product I'll be using to clean and dress basically every inch of this car's interior, excluding the carpet and glass, is CarPro's Inside. As I mentioned in my CarPro product video review, this is the first all-in-one interior cleaner and dresser that I've used that actually has the ability to effectively clean interior surfaces and leave an amazing finish that not only looks great, but is non-shiny or greasy and really seems to nourish and protect every surface it's applied to. It does feel a little greasy on your microfiber cloths, but don't let that fool you. The finish is far from it. The brilliant foaming action it produces helps safely lift and remove grime, and although it does take a bit more effort to wipe down, to achieve that beautiful, deep, even finish, it is still quicker than applying a separate cleaner and then following up with a dressing. It really couldn't be easier to apply. I like to spray directly onto my Swiss Vax interior brush, then work it over the surface, giving it a good fair few passes, making sure it's evenly applied and has a bit of time to penetrate the contaminants. It's then immediately mopped up with a microfiber cloth, and I'll continue to lightly wipe the surface until all the high spots are gone and I can see a nice uniform finish. This product is an absolute gem for light to moderate dirty interiors, as it will save time and give a superior finish and protection compared to most other products out there. But quite honestly, if I am dealing with a heavily soiled interior, it's not going to replace the need for my all-purpose cleaner and degreaser for their increased cleaning abilities. So much like the vacuuming stage, I'm going to be starting at the rear of the vehicle, working from top to bottom, and slowly making my way to the front of the cabin. On a side note, apart from working from top to bottom, which is really a good idea to avoid having to backtrack and re-clean areas, it's really up to you to decide where you want to start cleaning. But my advice is to just stay consistent with your routine, as it can be quite easy to miss an area when you keep changing your workflow method. And that can be a very time-consuming mistake if you don't catch it in time, or a very embarrassing and costly moment if your client points it out to you and you need to revisit the job to rectify it. A couple of things to note as well is that if you're working outside on hot days or in direct sunlight, it's really best to work very small areas at a time, regardless of what products you're using. And never let any of these cleaners dry on the surface or sit for too long before they're wiped off. And unless dealing with extremely bad interiors, I advise never to spray the products directly onto the surface, as they may very well stain and discolor the material, especially if the chemicals are allowed to drip and run. You'll also notice a few random spots in this interior that have more stubborn stains, where I'll use either my non-scratch scrubbing pad on the more sensitive surfaces or my magic sponge on the harder plastics to remove those more stubborn stains and marks. The key factor for me when dealing with these more prominent stains is to not be overly aggressive and use a lot of pressure. The best way to go about it is to use light pressure with the scrub pads and magic eraser and give the stain or mark multiple applications rather than one or two really hard applications that may damage the surface. You must also know when it's time to step back and leave a stain or mark alone, rather than further damage a trim or area. You can't always remove every defect in an interior, and my advice is to never guarantee that to anybody, as there's been a few times where I've been quite surprised at certain stains and marks that really didn't look all that bad upon inspection, but turned out to be virtually impossible to fully remove. Every defect is different. The surface and material it's on is different again, and how long it's been there and what actually caused it add more variables to the equation. So the best I can do or say is that I will try my best, and I always do. But for the most part, even if I can't remove it, I can almost always improve on it and at least make it less noticeable. Another point I'd like to make that's really important in particular for black or dark interiors is how to know when the surface, for example, the black leather seats, are actually clean. As unlike white or light colours, the dirt is far less obvious and harder to see. One thing that is always very telling to me is the finish on leather or vinyl seats. If you saw the pre-inspection, they looked quite shiny, almost glossy, and they felt very smooth and slippery. That isn't the way clean leather seats should look or feel. And a quick way for me to tell and identify that they really weren't cleaned at least not effectively. Clean leather should have more of a matte to satin finish, as well as more of a grip when you run your hands over it or sit in it. The shiny glossy finish you see is a combination of body oils, dirt, and various contaminants basically being rubbed and massaged into the seat as you sit, drive, and move around in it. The issue is that the longer these foreign particles are allowed to bond and sit on the leather, or just about any interior surface, the far quicker that material will deteriorate. If you look at trims such as steering wheels and gear knobs that are by far the worst affected areas, they are also by far the most touched areas. Another way to tell, as I demonstrated with the car mats, is to use a light coloured microfiber cloth to wipe the areas down. If they are clean, then your cloth will look likewise. So really, as you can see, for this part of the interior clean, all I'm using for 90% of the cleaning and dressing is CarPro Inside, my interior brush, and about half a dozen microfiber cloths. The other 10% of the cabin that has a few more stains, I'm using Inside with either my scrubbing pad or the Magic Eraser. If I didn't want to use CarPro Inside, I would use a light concentration of all-purpose cleaner and pretty much follow the same methods and steps, except I would then go over all the trims again with a dressing protectant at a later stage of the detail. Much like the primary vacuuming stage in part 1, I'm looking for 90 to 95% perfection here, as I'm always going to have to do a final inspection to even out any high spots and remove any handprints or smudges that are inevitably going to exist as I progress from one area to the next and then move on to extracting the carpets. I also want to briefly touch on the various types of interior cleaners, as it's a question I get asked a lot. If you have a bit of a look at what's available in the way of interior car cleaning chemicals, you'll come across dedicated carpet cleaners, fabric cleaners, leather cleaners, vinyl cleaners, and plastic trim cleaners, just to name a few. So by many car care brand standards, they would have you buy, carry, and use half a dozen different cleaners and another half dozen dressings to detail one interior. I realize that for many of you out there, you really want the best and safest products for both yourself and your business. And there is definitely a fear factor that the industry seems to thrive on, almost scaring people into thinking that if I don't use a dedicated leather cleaner for the leather, I'll ruin it. The truth of the matter is that 9 out of 10 of those dedicated cleaners are the same product, just at different concentrations. Or in the case of most leather cleaners, they are a cleaner mixed in with a dressing. It doesn't take all those dozens of products to effectively detail an interior, and quite honestly, many of them just aren't effective cleaners that use dressings to mask and give the impression that the surface is clean with a glossy finish that just hides the dirt rather than removing it. A quality all-purpose cleaner can be used at higher dilutions to clean your more sensitive surfaces and then mixed at stronger concentrations for your more stubborn and dirty areas, and can really be used on just about any surface. And in regards to safety, you'll find that just about every dedicated cleaner states on the label that you should always test it first on a small area before proceeding to clean the whole area with it. So if it really is a safe, dedicated cleaner, then why would they have to print that on the label? It comes down to what I said before about every surface, material, and situation being different. A little common sense mixed with a little experience or some testing is the only real safeguard against any product. So don't be fooled into thinking that certain products are better or safer than others just because of how they are marketed. It's up to you to test, research, and find out for yourself the truth about the products you're using, rather than what the manufacturer hypes them out to be. You'll find that certain areas, such as the dashboard, don't really require much cleaning as they rarely get touched. So spraying some product onto your microfiber cloth and just giving it a quick wipe is really all that's needed. And try to avoid using anything but an ammonia-free glass cleaner or just water on your microfiber cloth when it comes to cleaning the clear plastics and digital screens around the dash and cockpit. However, when it comes to the other areas, such as the driver's side position of cleaning, you'll find that this area generally needs the most work, as they are obviously the most used and touched areas of the whole cabin, except for perhaps minivans with kids and pets that are generally worse in the back seats. Essentially, a quality detail job really is about all the finer details in the end. So things like making sure the air vents are as clean as possible and getting all the built-up gunk off the stereo and various control knobs, as well as the steering wheel and surrounding controls, not forgetting to go down below to the driver pedals, is vital to really take the finish to the next level. The driver's seat is also perhaps an area that I generally need to go over more thoroughly to really get it clean to the same standard of the other seats. Well, that's just about it for part 2 of this series. Part 3 and the final episode will have a look at extracting the carpets, cleaning the inner glass and mirrors, sanitizing and further protecting the cabin, as well as the final inspection. I really hope some of you found this video useful. Please like, comment, and subscribe to show your support. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.